Hello students, a very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss disaster preparedness, its concept, nature and disaster preparedness plan. In our last lecture, we have discussed all the meaning, concepts and plan of disaster mitigation. And we already know that disaster mitigation and preparedness, these are the pre-planned disaster. This is the pre-planned disaster planning, and after disaster, the response and recovery are the main cyclic part of this process. This is the cyclic part, and before disaster can occur, these are the planning, pre-planned disasters, and after disaster, these are the response and recovery are the main part of this cycle. And in case of disaster mitigation, we have learned that the mitigation are actually the measures that are put in place so that after effects of disaster can be minimized. As we know, the main concern and the main objective of any disaster management cycle is to minimize the loss of life, loss of properties, and in every case the objective can be same. The objectives are also same, as the whole objective of the disaster management cycle is to minimize life and minimize the property loss. So in mitigation, we have already studied that this is a long term process, means planning, conducting the vulnerability analysis, risk analysis, zoning of the areas, building codes, formation, then land use management. So these plannings are included in disaster mitigation part. So this is a long term process, long term planning to minimize the loss of life and loss of property. But disaster preparedness short term management process. So that short-term planning process, so that here also the aim is same. The here also the aim, the basic aim for the preparedness is also to minimize the life loss. But this is short-term process and this is long-term process. So this is the basic difference between the mitigation and preparedness. You must be aware of the basic difference between preparedness and mitigation. Mitigation is the long term process, and preparedness is a short planning process. And here the various long term strategies are taken, and here short term planning strategies are taken. So both of these are pre-disaster activities. So all activities taken to reduce human and property losses due to potential hazard are included in this set. These are the pre-disaster part. So here the pre-disaster activities could include both of these can include the campaign, then also preparation and comprehensive disaster management plans at various levels, that can also other short-term plan also. Long-term plans are included in mitigation and short-term plans are included in preparedness. So in case of preparedness, there are various steps can include, and also it can enable the governments, organization and communities. So let's start with today's lecture. Today we are going to learn actually the meaning of disaster preparedness, though I have already discussed it. So then concept of disaster preparedness, and after that we will learn disaster preparedness measures and then the preparedness planning. So let's start with the meaning of preparedness. As I already said, the preparedness and mitigation both are at the part of these are the part of both disaster management cycle and both are in pre-disaster management cycle. Disaster preparedness refers to measures taken to prepare for and reduce the effects of disaster. So this is the basic aim, and that is to predict where possible, prevent them. If we can prevent them and mitigate their impact on vulnerable populations and respond to and effectively cope with their consequences. Consequences means effects. We can decrease, at least we can decrease the effects. Disaster preparedness is best viewed from the broad perspective and broad perspective, and also more appropriately conceived as a goal rather than specialized program or stage which immediately precedes the disaster response. So that if you can remember the cyclic process of disaster management cycle, then you can see after then mitigation and preparedness, then there is the response part. Means after disaster happened, then we have to respond. So response involves the initial actions these are taken. So this is the after disaster, post disaster part. But during disaster, so during disaster you have to respond, and after disaster, that is post disaster, is the recovery part. So the aim of the disaster management cycle and mitigation and preparedness are the same, that to reduce the property and life. And in case of mitigation, the mitigation can also be included in also the mitigation part. There are the various types of building codes designed, but here this is short term process. And let's discuss the concept of preparedness. The disaster preparedness is a continuous and integrated process resulting from a wide range of activities and resources rather than a distinct sectoral activity by itself. It requires the contributions of many different areas, ranging from training and logistics to healthcare institutional development, viewed from the broad perspective. So these are the main concept of disaster preparedness. And disaster preparedness, if you compare with the mitigation involves risk analysis, vulnerability analysis, means these are some statistical part, zoning and land use management, building codes use regulation, then safety codes, then prevention of healthcare, then public education. And in case of preparedness, it includes the planning, education and training. This is the training, so this is the real application. Preparedness, planning, education, training, education, then public information, then evacuation plans, how to evacuate people, then creating resource inventors, and the mutual and agreements. Mutual and agreements, that means the various insurance, you can say. So these are the planning part, and these are included in preparedness. Now I think now it is clear what is the basic difference between the disaster mitigation and disaster preparedness. And also you can see that the concept of disaster preparedness can here we can say with this, that the increasing the efficiency, effectiveness and impact of disaster emergency response. So how to increase the efficiency and effectiveness, for this we need the training of the volunteers, and then the strengthening community based disaster preparedness through national society programs. That means here also we can include some campaigns, and through the social media, through the electronic media, and then developing activities that are useful for both addressing everyday risk that the continuous phase and for responding to disaster situation. Here, for example, you can say that the health, first aid, social welfare programs that have the components useful for disaster reduction and response means first aid. We have to ensure the healthcare facilities and also some basic needs of human being. So these are some short-term planning. We have to be prepared for any disaster. And this is included in the concept of preparedness. Now, disaster preparedness measures means how or what are the strategies we can take to measure to control any disaster effect. And here, disaster preparedness is a broad concept that describes a set of measures that minimize the adverse effect of hazard, including loss of life and property and disruption of livelihood. So this is the basic aim. Then disaster preparedness is achieved partially through readiness measures that expedite the emergency response. Rehabilitation means the affected community we have to rehabilitate, means we have to give us the habitat, the home or other basic needs for their livelihood, to control their loss and the recovery and result in rapid and timely targeted assistance. It is also achieved through community-based approaches, and community-based approaches means with the various awareness campaigns and that build the capacities of people and communities to cope with and minimize the effects of disaster in their life. So these are the some plans how to decrease the disaster management at this step. This how to decrease the disaster effects. So I think now it is clear what are the preparedness measures taken. Then preparedness planning, how to plan. The concept of preparedness planning is very important. As we know, for every task we have to be prepared for, and we have a proper planning process so that we can go forward with a proper planning process, and also with the planning only we can achieve our goal. So in disaster management also, during an actual emergency means after the disaster happened, a quick and effective action is required. That is the part of the response. This action often depends on having made and implemented preparedness plan. So if we don't have any plan, then we cannot respond at the time of a disaster. So the planning, proper planning is very much needed. If appropriate action is not taken, if the response is delayed, if proper planning, here is the planning process. If the proper planning is not taken, then we cannot respond at the time of the disaster in a preliminary plan also, even though the details of disaster remain uncertain. So then you can identify emergency shelter sites, plan, publicize evacuation routes. So we have to know about this in the disaster mitigation, disaster preparedness plan. So the shelter sites, we have to know the shelter sites, then plan and publicize the evacuation route. We must be aware of that. So these parts, identify emergency water sources, determine chains and command and communication procedures, and train, response, personal, evacuate, educate people. So these the underlined part. These are the included in disaster preparedness. Means we have to know the shelter site. We have to know how to evacuate the affected community. We have to know about the identity emergency water. We have to identify the emergency water sources, and also to determine and the command and communication procedures, how to and to whom we have to communicate at this time, and also we have to train some other volunteers and personnel and educate people. So these are main planning of preparedness. So I think now you are now very much clear about the difference between the mitigation and preparedness. In mitigation, these are not included, but aim for both are same. But in case of mitigation, a very broad sense in very long term process, risk analysis, public education, prevention, healthcare. So these are the preventive healthcare. So these are included in mitigation. But preparedness is a short term planning process. Now preparedness planning process. The disaster preparedness plans involves identifying organizational resources. We have to know about the resources, then determine roles and responsibilities, to whom we can give the responsibility, to the NGOs or to other social activists, and the developing policies and procedures and planning of preparedness. We have to plan about this. In our last slide, we have discussed an activities aimed at ensuring timely disaster preparation and effective emergency response. So ultimately, we have to focus to the response part. So if we are planned in a very effective way, then if we have a plan with very effective way, then only we can respond at the time of disaster in a very efficient way. Otherwise, without planning process, it is difficult to cope up with the disaster. So in today's lecture, we are now able to understand what is disaster preparedness and what are the differences between disaster preparedness and mitigation, and what are the basic strategies for disaster preparedness and also planning for disaster preparedness. So today, up to this, see you in the next class, and thank you for your attention.